This presentation is a production of the Animal Science Department at Purdue University.
Hi, this is Ralph Williams at Purdue. I'm in the Entomology Department, Extension Livestock Entomologist. I'm going to talk about pasture fly control. And as we get into that, we really need to look at the effects that arthropod pests have on pastured cattle. You know, they'll lead to reduced weight gains, less efficient use of forages. There's also treatment cost of arthropod-borne disease, and there's also direct physical harm of damage by the arthropods themselves, cattle being nervous, that sort of thing. There's also that labor cost involved with the cost of control. I want to start by talking about one of the major fly pests that we see on pastured cattle, and that's the horn fly. It's named the horn fly because historically it was found actually resting on the horns of cattle. But obviously we have a lot of cattle that don't have horns, but these flies are the ones you normally see in large numbers on the backs of cattle. They are a blood-sucking fly, and they really spend most of their time in the adult stage actually on the animals. Now, horn flies are worldwide. They're found in all cattle-producing regions of the world, especially in Europe, North Africa, Asia Minor, and the Americas. There's also a subspecies found called the buffalo fly that's actually found down in Australia. I had the opportunity a few years ago to be down in South America, and although we've had horn flies since the late 1800s, it had just been introduced into Brazil in the last 15 to 20 years. As I indicated, they're worldwide, but they are found in all parts of North America. They are considered the most important pest of range cattle on the continent. They were introduced into North America on cattle shipments from Europe in the late 1880s. The first adult horn flies were collected in New Jersey in 1887, and by 1898, they were found from the East Coast all the way to the Rocky Mountains, and of course today, they're in every state of the Union and also found in South America now. They are a blood-sucking fly. They're smaller than other muscoid flies, similar to house flies and face flies. They're just a bit smaller. They feed almost exclusively on cattle, and both sexes are blood feeders. They're continuous obligatory parasites in the adult stage. What that means basically is that the adult flies are going to stay right on the animals at all times. They'll feed several times a day, and only the females will leave to lay eggs on fresh, very fresh cattle manure, and then get right back on the animal. The female flies will oviposit eggs in fresh cattle dung soon after it's dropped, just within a few minutes. And they lay about 400 eggs at a time, in a lifetime, 20 to 24 at a time. Again, that's 400 eggs in a lifetime, and about a couple dozen at a time. They have a 10 to 14 day life cycle under optimal conditions and summertime type conditions. Large numbers can occur on cattle, especially in the southern United States. I've observed as many as 10,000 flies per bull. This has been reported. I've actually seen this in Oklahoma when I spent a few years there. Here in Indiana, numbers we normally see anywhere from 1,000 to 4,000 are relatively common during the midsummer. We've actually observed that year after year. I do a lot of cattle work in southern Indiana and also up here in north central Indiana, and that's the type of numbers that we see on untreated cattle during the summer. This can represent a significant blood loss because you got to realize all those flies on the cattle are taking multiple blood meals every day. Now, fly abundance, you may have a split in populations depending on the summer temperatures. In this area of the country, we usually see one midsummer peak. However, if warm conditions start early and in late, we may see actually two peaks, one early and one late in the summer. As far as economic loss, there have been studies shown, these studies in the Southwest, in Texas and Oklahoma, have actually showed up to a tenth of a kilogram average daily gain loss, and also of 7.7% feed efficiency loss. So these flies are considered of economic importance. And around 200 flies per head or per animal is really what we call the economic threshold. And when we're talking 1,000 to 4,000 flies per animal, this is very much justifiable to go ahead and initiate a control program. One other blood-sucking fly that we have started to see more than usual is another blood-sucking muscoid fly, and that's the stable fly. We typically think stable flies as a confinement cattle pest, but and these actually feed on the lower parts of the body, especially on the legs of cattle, and cattle will be appeared to be stomping their feet, doing a lot of tail swishing and that sort of thing, just being bothered. We have found that with the use of large round bales of hay that may be kept out in the field, and if that hay is broken up and stomped on by cattle, this actually causes a significant breeding source for these flies. They actually will breed in the decomposing plant materials of this hay. And in the center core of a big round bale, as it may tend to get wet and rot, this actually creates a breeding spot for these flies as well. But again, as opposed to the horn flies actually breed in fresh manure. Stable flies will breed in decomposing plant material such as in the round bales.
This presentation was a production of the Animal Science Department at Purdue University.